Power interruptions hit polling precincts in Quezon City, where automated voting for the village and youth council polls is being pilot tested. The school's electrician says the power source for the actual vote counting machines seemed to be the source of the issue. But the electoral board chairpersons and the technicians assures the public the records of those who voted earlier in the day were not compromised.
Dahil nga po hindi siya naka-direct sa outlet and possible na naging maluwag po yung sa kuryente natin and ayun po, dinerecho na lang po para po tuloy-tuloy na po, wala na po yung maging aberya.
Kung makikita po nila, andito pa rin po yung 39 votes for barangay and then 6 votes for SK. And voting is now open po ulit.
Nagkaroon na po kami ng electricity, so nag-start na po yung VCM. Good thing po is nandun pa rin po yung mga records, yung mga votes, pati po yung names namin na naka-encode po dun sa VCM.
Meanwhile, voting in one school in Tondo, Manila goes beyond the 3 p.m. deadline due to a huge turnout in voters. More than 44,000 people are registered to cast their votes at Gregorio Perfect High School. This is due to the ongoing renovations at the other voting center in the area. The school's principal says lines have spilled over to the streets and at least one senior citizen fainted while waiting to vote. Vote counting has begun in most polling precincts across the Philippines. Voting for the village and youth council polls officially closed at 3 p.m. The Philippine Elections Commission eyeing to proclaim winning candidates by 10 to 10:30 p.m. today. COMELEC says the counting of ballots in villages may finish at around 8 to 8:30 p.m. The poll body also reported 168 reports of vote buying. 28 cases were filed prior to today's elections, while 46 complaints are expected to be filed anytime today. COMELEC is already evaluating 94 complaints for further evidence.
Napakalaking bagay po nito kung ituturing natin na nung 2022 elections, there were 1,200 plus complaints of vote buying. Draw your conclusions from that, but for us, this is a very positive and encouraging sign that our efforts have borne fruit and we are very grateful for the participation of our stakeholders.
The canvassing of votes has begun in Pasig City. Let's get the latest from our correspondent, Jose Carretero. Jose?
Good afternoon, Denise. Canvassing of votes is now ongoing here at Rizal High School in Pasig City. According to Deputy Supervisor Official Richard Santos, voting went well despite the big number of voters from Barangay Kanyugan, Pasig, with 19,993 registered voters. The school has 53 cluster precincts with 159 electoral board assigned. Santos said there have been no major problems in the conduct of the BSKE. Medical team is on standby for those who will be needing assistance. Santos said some senior citizen voters need to be assisted by the medical team due to dizziness. Some have elevated blood pressure. Santos said they expect canvassing ballots from each precinct will finish around 7 onward. The canvass ballots will be brought at the school gym where consolidation will be done. With a big number of voters, we expect winners will be proclaimed early dawn tomorrow. Meanwhile, at around 1 p.m., Eastern Police District Director Brigadier General Wilson Asueta inspected the vicinity of the polling centers. He says the ongoing BSK elections in his area of responsibility is so far generally peaceful. Around 2,300 PNP personnel have been deployed, according to Asueta. In Pasig City, 6 persons were arrested last night for violation of the liquor ban. Asueta said they will provide security until the winners are proclaimed. The election materials were returned to the treasurer's office and the teachers and COMELEC officials have safely returned to their offices. Denise.
Thanks, Jose. Now, thousands of inmates across the Philippines exercise their right to vote through special polling precincts in penal facilities. Bianca Dava joins us on the line for the details. Bianca.
Hi, Denise. A total of 203 persons deprived of liberty or PDLs at the Manila City Jail have casted their votes for the Barangay and Sangguniang Kabataan elections, or BSKE, on Monday. Of this number, 278 are males and 25 are females. We spoke to two PDLs earlier who told us that they hope whoever wins in the local polls would also include the needs of the inmates in their program. The PDLs at the Manila City Jail are among the 26,000 PDLs nationwide that are eligible to vote inside special polling precincts established within the jail. Another 1,600 were escorted by jail officers to the respective registered precincts in the barangays. Interior Secretary Benhur Abalos and Bureau of Jail Management and Penology, or BJMP Chief, Jail Director Roel Rivera personally visited the Manila City Jail earlier to ensure the seamless execution of the voting process there. The BJMP Chief noted that videos of the candidates' campaign platforms were shown to the PDLs to help them choose their political leaders. In other words, campaigning was done virtually. Abalos also said that aside from voting, the PDLs were also allowed to run in the BSKE. In fact, two PDLs nationwide ran for barangay chairman, while six others ran for the barangay Kagawad post. According to the COMELEC rules, inmates who are formally charged and awaiting trial and those serving prison sentences of less than a year are qualified to vote in the local polls. Earlier this month, the COMELEC signed a deal with the BJMP and the Public Attorney's Office on the implementation of PDLs voting for the BSKE. Denise?
Thanks, Bianca.